our first selection is taken from the movie Titanic, and it's taken from the scene as the boat is sinking, and the musicians stay and play their way to a watery death with the music. But I think, and that can be gruesome, but it can also be really, I think it's more beautiful and poetic and a really amazing scene. And, so I hope you enjoy the calming effect.
Thank you. Teaching through the arts motivates children and increases their aptitude for learning.
Who plays that G flat? Push through. Cool. It's a good thing I'm a vocal teacher. Here's one. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a chord. Beautiful. Everybody, 49, do it every time for good luck, please. Woo! This is one of our
You like that? Thank you. Music in the Mountains would not be able to do this without the help of so many people. So I'd first like to thank Alpine Bank is the sponsor of this event. Those cards. Alpine Bank does amazing things to help support all education in our community, so thank you to them. The wonderful programs and flyers that you see were made by Scott Hagler at Third Avenue Arts, so thank you to them. Thank you to the Department of Music, that drumline, that amazing drumline that you saw. That's the FLC Skyhawk Strikeforce drumline, and they're everywhere. They're awesome. And thank you to all of the faculty members and everyone that made this possible. Of course, the Community Concert Hall. Without them, we would not be here tonight. So huge, huge thank you to them, as well as the Mead Frank Foundation, the Bayfield Elementary students that are sitting right here that started the show. Thank you to them for coming out and showing us what Bayfield is doing. That being said, looks like we're almost ready. I would love if you all would help me give a big thank you to the music instructors that make this possible. Lek Usinowitz, Denon Jones, Evelyn Black, Rusty Charpentier, Katharine Reed, did I forget anyone? Molly Jensen, thank you. Without them, these students would not be. In our community, and I can't thank them enough for all that they do for this community and for our music programs. Okay, so last but not least, we have our combined orchestra, symphony, winds, brass, everything up on stage right here, right now, and we are lucky enough to have Dr. Mark Walters, the director of bands at Fort Lewis College, that was able to come in and give them a little clinic and rehearsal this afternoon for about an hour. So this piece, all together, they've done for about an hour, and I think you guys will be pleasantly surprised. So if you could all help me welcome Dr. Mark Walters.
Thank you, everybody. Good evening. It's a pleasure to be here. Please have a seat. Winds and strings and percussion. Well, they don't have seats, so they understand. I would like to take a couple of seconds here. I noticed the screens playing tonight, and how fortunate it is that we're explaining or sharing with you the research that has been proven as far as music education and the benefits of the mind and so forth. And I plan to mention something about that, but I think the wonderful students at DHS that filmed that really did a beautiful job of sharing that. We are at a time here in this area in the Four Corners, where in Durango and in Bayfield, we have some of our strongest music education going on. And I want to recognize and thank those teachers. Some of them are graduates, so it's really heartfelt to see them doing such a wonderful job in front of the audience and speaking to the audience and working with the students on stage. So please, let's give our educators a round of applause. Of course, wonderful students on stage came in this afternoon at around 4 o'clock and worked with them on this piece. It's a very fun closer for the concert, but I do want to share one thing that's related to all of these benefits, and it was I've thought about it a long time and I wondered whether it was appropriate to share it. Several years ago, I went to dinner with a colleague in the music department, faculty member, her 17-year-old son, and a cardiologist in town. We were sitting at dinner, and
the young man brought up the notion, I'm going to college, I want to be a doctor, what should I major in? And much to our surprise, he said, well, you love playing the trumpet in the band at DHS, have you thought about music? And the three of us, our jaws dropped to the ground. We laughed and then finally said, no, you don't understand. He said, music majors are highly coveted in medical school. And so he went on to explain the reasons, and the reasons are just what we talked about. The right brain, left brain correlation, the advanced math skills, the advanced reading and comprehension skills leadership skills, the diligent hours it takes in the practice room, the ability to creatively and abstractly solve problems. He said all of these are very, very appealing to medical students. Yes, you have to make your grades, you have to take the right science classes, but I thought we couldn't believe this. And so I looked it up, and they said that the acceptance rate of music majors into medical school is 66%, as opposed to biochemistry, which is 40%.
Wow.
Think about that for a moment. Now, of course, the numbers are much larger. There's many more biochemistry majors applying for medical school. But the point is that this young man did just that. He got a performance degree in trumpet, and he went on to medical school. Now he's a successful practicing ears, nose, and throat specialist in Denver, Colorado. So, you know, that's sort of, I'm not suggesting that all of these students become doctors by being music majors in college, but what I'm trying to get the point across is that the higher brain functions that the students develop, they're there, they're real. These are the best students in our schools. And they're probably the students that are the busiest, and they stay out of trouble. These students are going to be in trouble because they can't move an inch in either direction. So anyway, it's funny because athletics is great for the body, and it's wonderful. We need that physical conditioning and so forth. But there's a certain point where you can't play a rigorous sport like football, basketball, and baseball, and you have to say, it's time to stop. Music is not that way. Play music your entire life. It's even been proven that playing a musical instrument and or learning a foreign language in your later years in life will prevent or ward off the onset of Alzheimer's disease. So there are so many benefits that we're studying about music and the way it works in life. I do want to thank the directors for allowing me to do this. Music is so important. It heals our soul. It feeds us, it nourishes us, and in some ways I believe without it, we would be facing a completely different society, especially at a time when things are so troubled and so anxious and so full of conflicts. So please hang on to this, and I promise this, if you encourage the young ones to stay in this and continue, you'll see so many changes both academically and socially. So, with that said, it's all good. Thank you very much.